False and misleading statements to law enforcement and prosecuting attorney is a crime?
Yeah.
False and misleading statement that I sent an email to the Brandon or Quilcene School District?
Yes.
That's a felony. It's a school. Now, this idea that you're going to misprison all this felony? You know, it's not just you, Jefferson County and Clallam County. I'm actually wanting to sue every police officer in every police station. And every time I can get them from misprisoning any of these felonies right now, I will sue them and I will have them prosecuted. And for all of you that decide to compound these prosecutions right now, why don't you give me the prosecuting attorneys and the district attorneys in each and every county and city of the United States? I will tell you,
yes,
if you are employed in any city government right now, tribal government, I want all 4 million of you. I want the personal assets of all 4 million. Now, somebody said,
yes,
we just don't prosecute. Even though it says here that this is a false police report and a false statement made to the prosecuting attorney's office. You refused to admit the evidence that I was in Port Angeles that day. And you had approximately a year and a half's worth of emails, about a million of them. And that day you had 2,000 emails to prove I wasn't there and I wasn't emailing that school district. So your subversive form of government where you pay dogs,
yes,
to play the part of citizens, so that you can get citizens arrested for crimes
right now.
It's subversive. I want to sue all 4 million of you. Every oath of office in every state of the United States, every individual that leave. I don't just want this county, Jefferson County. I don't just want this state. I want all 50 states. And I want to sue right now. Every one of you, all 4 million. Now, I've asked you to prosecute.
Yes.
I've said that in numerous emails. Poop. And for some reason, you keep coming the money. When it is actually subversive to the constitutional form of government.
Yes.
See, it says here, the constitutional form of the government of the United States or of the state of Washington. And then there's what's known as a political subdivision. Now, this violence against myself and my family?
Yes.
These false police reports and these false accusations?
Yes.
This would be known as force and violence. And if you're in that very special family where you thought?
Yes.
That you owned the county? It could be a revolution. Now, I'm going to prove?
Yes.
That each and every one of you right now had decided to have a revolution against the actual government of the United States because you thought your way of forgery, fraud, and felony,
yes,
was something you could do, even though it does violate the state of Washington,
yes,
the United States, and then the political subdivisions known as the politics of various counties and cities. Now, if the sheriff,
right,
would, okay, prosecute,
yes,
I would like my sons, pooped, I'd like you to prosecute Brent Paisden,
which,
Judge Porter, any Superior Court judge that are involved that decided to compound all of this,
yes,
and all of you in the police and sheriff's departments that have any knowledge of the use of forgery, fraud, or felony. Now, maybe Sheriff Bill Benedict would like to start this whole process of prosecuting. You have to initiate it. Now, it's called compounding, Sheriff. It's called compounding. You cannot refrain from initiating the prosecution for a crime when you have the evidence of the crime. You can't say, well, we're just not going to enforce his rights. We're not going to give him his sons. Yes. And we're going to refuse to prosecute Mike Van Poyne so that he won't be able to speak to Marilyn Van Poyne. You have to actually prosecute any time. Well, I'm sorry, but I actually do want them. I want all five sons. Yes. I want to live with Marilyn and her six kids. That's right.